Hello, hello, Crossroads witches and other interesting magical beings. I bet y'all can't guess where I'm at. My favorite place in the whole wide world with the dead folk. I am up here at this cemetery because if I say it out loud, they'll come. The name across the bottom of the screen is where I'm at. And I want to give y'all just a quick turnabout. Let me flip y'all. It is a beautiful, wonderful, overcast, rainy day. It is absolutely perfect for walking with dead folk. And I want to show y'all a little something. So I've got a friend here with me and I just showed her my trick. These are what I bring. You get a pack of these little breakfast toasts. And this is what I use for my food offering. If I feel compelled, I'll take a little piece off and I'll leave it somewhere either up around the actual gravestone itself, or I may leave it up front if I feel that that's the proper place. There is no place where you must leave it at on top, on the left side, in the center. Somebody done left some pretty little flowers for her. I assume that's a child. Actually, it is. She died at 7. I see it, 1902 to 1909. But it's about how you feel. Working with the dead is intuitive. I can't tell you what the dead are trying to tell you, all right? And what the dead are trying to tell me is my own personal message. Don't you just love some of this artwork? Tell me this just isn't some of the prettiest. Here's an iron gate. Iron was often put around the graves to keep spirits in, because we didn't want them leaving, and also to make sure that we keep those evil spirits, entities, out of the spaces. There's that haunting beauty that's throughout all graveyards. I don't feel like I need to say much at this point, just sort of show y'all how beautiful this cemetery, the one that I'm not gonna say out loud, I almost said its name. I was talking about, if you look at the cemetery, you notice that she's on wide corridors with these open areas. And the cemetery was designed to allow people to come in and picnic, where you could park your car and then you would set up your picnic area in front of this tomb. And something else you see throughout a lot of the southern graveyards are the stones of remembrance. If you look up at this one, you'll see that there are several stones of remembrance on there. Here's another stone of remembrance that somebody put down. It seems like a lot of times I see the stacks on the children's graves. We were talking about that we need to, oh y'all, heavy equipment going by. I'm just gonna let it run, y'all can see it. Here we go. And a heavy equipment went by. But if you really pay attention to a lot of these family plots, the majority of the graves are children. It is so sad to see the small graves, but understanding that child mortality, you know, up until, you know, well into the 1920s, the 1930s, was well at 50%, if not above. And so, unfortunately, we have lots of little babies. Stones of remembrance. If we go up into this plot, you're gonna come over people have asked me about this, and this is CSA, Confederate States of America. That means that one of the members of this family fought in the Civil War for the Confederacy. And how we make peace with these folks, and understanding they were folks, they had their own complexities, just like we do. And some of them, they didn't understand all of it. Others of them damn well knew what they were doing. But this is part of the funky gumbo that makes the Low Country. There's my offering. I left one of my little pieces of toast. I don't think I can even get in close to tell the story, but if you read in the book, you can also Google little Gracie Watson and find out more about her. Tell me that just isn't the most beautiful oak tree. Isn't that spectacular? Some things you just can't take a picture of to truly convey the majesty, to truly convey the beauty of it. It's just magical. Absolutely magical. Is that not the most magical base? It looks like little fairy holes. How beautiful. Oh, to be so lucky to be buried under such a beautiful tree. How amazing. And remember, we don't touch the Spanish moss. Spanish moss is full of red bugs, chiggers. They're these little red bugs that get up under your skin. Don't touch it. You say Bonadventure, they will copyright claim you. Seriously. Well, this footage here, I just plan on muting and overlaying with music. Some of the other video, though, that's what I was talking about. I'm at a cemetery, and if you look below, you'll see where it is. And that's where I just type in Bonadventure. And they do not give permission to film very often here. Beautiful, aren't they?